Hello everybody, my name is Gustavo Galas from copahost.com web hosting. In this video I'm going to show you how to work with meta tags in HTML5. First of all, what is a meta tag? Meta tag is some hidden part of your HTML5 page. Meta tags are very important for your web browser so that you can just show the browser how to deal and how to display properly your web page, and also for the search engines just like Google. This way you can just show the search engines how to index and how to describe your site properly. There are hundreds and hundreds of meta tags available for us to work with in HTML. In this video, we are going to talk about the 6 most important meta tags. They are description, keyword, viewport, robots, title, and refresh. As I told you in the beginning of the video, most of the meta refresh are hidden. It's important, first of all, to remember that all the meta tags must be inserted inside the head of your HTML file. All the meta tags should go here, inside this head section. First of all, I'm going to talk about the title meta tag. The title meta tag is simply the page title that will be shown on the tab of a web browser. In this web page, as we don't have a title set, you can see here on the tab the name of the file we are editing. As it's a local file, you can see the file name here on the tab, in the place of the title. If it was a remote file, we would see the URL of it. So for instance, the title meta tag is slightly different from the other meta tags. Let's set the title of this web page, first of all. But this is the title tag. This is slightly different from the other meta tags, actually. We simply have to place the page title inside them. Let's check. So I have just placed the title inside the tag title. Let's save the page and check how it works. So now we have here the page title set on the tab. Remember that the page title must be limited. The ideal number of characters are, let's say, 30, 35. Just don't go over this. I can also recommend a smaller title. Most of the people have many tabs open on their web browser. The smaller your title is, the best people will read it. For Google, it's recommended not to overlap 30 or 35 characters on the title. The meta description tag is one of the most important. This is simply essential for you to show the search engines, like Google, how to index and how to describe your website. The meta description tag must contain the description of your web page. Let's say if you're talking about your dog, you must have a description talking about your dog briefly. But remember, a meta description can't be so long. It must be limited to, let's say, 150 or 160 characters. I'll show you right now the behavior of the meta tag description on Google. For instance, this is a Google search results. This blue part is the title tag, the contents of the title tag. Now here we can see the meta description. In this page specifically, someone just placed the description over 150 characters, as you can see the 3 points here. Let's say you don't have a meta description. Google in this case will simply retrieve the content of your web page and place as a description on the search results. This is actually not good, as Google prioritizes pages with meta descriptions correctly set. By having a correct and accurate meta description, you are simply telling Google or the search engines your page is right about that keyword you are looking for. In other words, a great meta description influences a lot on your SEO. And websites with a great SEO receives lots of visitors. Now let's switch to the Firefox browser. It has a better control over the meta tags. First of all, you must keep in mind that the meta tags are hidden, but there is a method for you to check them. I have just switched to the Firefox browser. Now I'm willing to click with the right button of the mouse. And now I'm going to view page info. As you can see, there is nothing showing here because our page currently only have the title, which isn't really a meta tag. It's part of the meta tags, but not a standard meta tag. So it will show an empty space here. Now let's make the first tag, the meta tag of description. So this is how the meta tag looks like. This is the name attribute where you can place the name of the meta tag, in this case the description meta tag, and then content, which is the content of the meta tag. Every meta tag must have these two attributes, name and content. So this meta tag is about the description, its name is description, and the content goes here, inside the attribute content. The search engines have robots. Robots is a big server that visits, crawls every page on the web. This is called indexing. It copies the content, the text content of the page, it copies the images, and also the meta tags, your title, description, and other meta tags. We'll talk more about these robots in the end of this video. So, as we have the meta tag description created, let's save the page and see if anything changes on the page. As I have just reloaded the page, nothing happens, because as I told you, the meta tags are hidden. To check the content of a meta tag, we must do this. We must click with the right button of the mouse. Now click View Page Info. Now we can see here, meta tag, one tag, name, which is the description meta tag, and the content, the web page about Boris the dog. So if you can see the meta tag content here, that means it's working correctly. To test your meta tags, we can recommend Firefox. It's a great browser with a great control. Now let's talk about the meta keywords tag. For the meta keywords tag, we are telling the search engines which keywords this page is about. Now I will create a meta tag. Keep in mind that keywords is in the plural. So the meta tag keywords looks just like as the description. We have here the name attribute and the content attribute. Just keep in mind that in the content attribute, we must place the keyword separated by a comma. In our sample, we have the name keywords, always in the plural, don't forget it, and the content dog, comma Boris, which is the name of the dog, comma Yorkshire, comma pets. In the meta keywords tag, I recommend you using no more than 10 keywords. It's an important way to tell the search engines which keywords your page is about. You can use anything under 10 keywords, it's fine to use 1, 2, 3, it's not a problem. Now let's talk about the robots meta tag. In the robots meta tag, you can whether authorize or not the search engines to index that page. There are many web pages with important information, private information, that you simply don't want the robots, the search engines to index. So you can simply deny or block them, preventing them from searching and from indexing your content in the web. So this is how the meta tag robots look like. So this is a sample robots meta tag with the content index and follow. By using the content index, comma, follow, you're talking to the search engine, please index my page and please follow my links. There are some other options in this meta tag for you to use. In this video, to be brief, we're just talking about the index and the follow attributes. Using index and follow is a recommended configuration for those who want your website to be indexed. Let's say you don't want this website to be indexed. Let's say you have a page with private information and you don't want this to appear in the search engines. You must simply change here for no index. By using the noindex attribute, you are simply talking to the search engines. Please don't index my webpage. I don't want this page to be listed in Google. Let's talk about the follow attribute. If you had one or more links on it, Google would follow these links, crawl all these links. You can place simply nofollow to tell Google, Google, do not follow the links in this web page, even if the links are internal to the same website or even if the links are external to other websites. So my recommendation is always using index and follow, which is the standard configuration for you to have your website indexed by Google. So now let's talk about the Viewport meta tag. The Viewport meta tag will adjust your website to mobile phones. In this sample, we have the web page, the default web page, without any modification, without the viewport meta tag. Let's just create a meta tag and you will see the difference. So the viewport meta tag have two elements. First of all, width and initial scale. We should use the width as device width, just like in the sample, and the initial scale equals 1.0. Let me show you the difference. So first of all, let's save this. Now we have the Firefox, the desktop browser. Let's see how it looks like. So I have just reloaded the web page and we can see no difference here. In Firefox and also in Google Chrome, there is a way to emulate a mobile phone. This way we can just see the web page, just like it would appear in the mobile phone. Now I'm going to click here in the mobile simulator. Here you can just choose the model of the mobile. I'm testing in iPhone X. Okay, so let's just reload the page. So I have just reloaded the page and this is how it looks like with the meta tag viewport. For instance, I'm going to change the initial scale from 1 to 2. Let's save the page and reload it with F5. Now as you can see, there is a big zoom on the page. The default best configuration is 1.0. Let's just come back to 1.0, save and reload here. So we're back to normal. Now I'm willing to remove this meta tag for you to see how the page looks like in the mobile phone without the viewport meta tag. I'm going to save the web page and reload. Now you can see how it would look like without the viewport meta tag. As you can see, the viewport meta tag is very important so that your site appears nicely in the mobile devices. Let's just bring it back and reload again the page. That's it. Now let's talk about the meta refresh tag. The meta refresh tag can be used for basically two reasons. First is to refresh a web page from time to time or to make a redirection to another page. Let's see how it looks like. So as you can see, this tag is slightly different from the others. So in this meta tag, I used HTTP quiv instead of name. What does it mean? The HTTP quiv means to simulate a server-side response header. This is a standard for the meta refresh and meta content meta tags. So I have used the meta refresh tag with the content too. That means the page will reload automatically every 2 seconds. Let's see how it looks like. Let's save the page and reload here. That means the page is reloading every 2 seconds. If we set here, let's say for 20, the page will reload every 20 seconds, not 2. Another important configuration for this meta tag is placing the URL here. So as I have set, 20 seconds for the refresh time and URL equal copahost.com. That means that after 20 seconds, the page will reload to this URL set. Now in this sample, I have set 5 seconds and refreshing to a new URL, copahost.com. Let's see how it looks like. Let's reload the page. So I have just reloaded, and after 5 seconds, it simply redirects, refreshes to a new URL. So I will need now to increase this number of seconds so that we can check the web page. I will need to save and reload it. So least but not less, let's see how the meta tags look like in the browser. Let's click with the right button. Now click View Page Info. Now we can see all the meta tags configured in a website. So thanks for watching. If you have any questions, just place a comment in this video. Thank you.